Hey folks, if you're looking to do this bookkeeping, accounting, and tax firm, start your own bookkeeping business, I think you should look at my outsourced accountant model. But today what I want to talk about is your biggest, worst enemy. Your biggest, worst enemy when you're trying to build this type of company up. You see, if you're going to be an outsourced accountant, if you're a tax person, a bookkeeper, or an accountant, chances are you are a detail-oriented, systems-oriented person. Not only that, if you are formally trained, you have a bias towards only thinking about one thing and one thing only, and that's cost. Cost is what you think of, because you're an accountant. You're literally counting the costs of things, right? And if you're trying to build your own bookkeeping, tax, and accounting firm, if you're trying to build up this outsourced accountant firm, no matter what it is, if you think about costs, how much you cost to your customers, you're gonna be in trouble, okay? Now, a bunch of you know that. A bunch of you know that, and yet, deep down inside of you, you have a fear or you have a bias where you think something is too expensive. You know how I know this is true? Because my partner, Nick Meester at Nuance Financial Tax and Accounting, it doesn't matter what we were doing, who we were pitching to, particularly in the early days, he would always get bent out of shape about the price we were going to propose to a business owner for our services to be their outsourced accountant. He would get all nervous, and when I'd run a meeting with him, I would kind of frame things up and show the customer, well, we're going to take care of this stuff. I think you're going to save this type of taxes, scratching my nose, and it's going to be $800 a month for us to do that. How do you like that? And Nick, you could just feel his anxiety start to raise. What if they say no? Now, he was concerned about what if they say no, and what would happen is, if they had any hesitancy, a little butthead would speak up, and he would say, well, you know, since you're small and you're just trying to get ready, why don't we just do it for $400 a month? And he'd stink and undercut us all the time. And the main reason why is because you as accountants and CPAs and bookkeepers are hardwired to consider costs heavily. You just are. No matter what, my experience has been that most accountants that are married, when you look at their spouse, they have the yin and yang. The accountant is almost always the tight-laced, disciplined, watching the finances, more conservative, generally speaking, than the other spouse. They always have the other ones, the gregarious, sales-focused. Dave Ramsey talks about this a lot too. So you got to identify that in you. When you're prospecting or when you're presenting, remember, you want to run a meeting cycle where you connect with people for an hour to get to know them and their business, show them a little bit about what you do, pique their interest with some great questions around S Corps, retirement plans and whatnot. Then you want to do a deep analysis, get your hands on that tax return, get your hands on their payroll reports, get your hands in their books. Just say, hey, can I get your logins for QuickBooks? Let me take a look at what you got. And then come back with a great proposal. But this isn't about how do you get a higher billing. This is more about you have to think through what's most valuable to a customer, okay? Businesses should be, wise businesses should be and are most concerned not with cost, but with efficiencies. Efficiency, efficiency, efficiency. For example, my dad sells Caterpillar equipment. Caterpillar equipment, heavy machinery, is always 30%, 20% more expensive than Volvo and John Deere. But as the official Cat dealership, when they sell a machine, their value proposition isn't the 30% price. It's downtime and efficiencies. If that person behind the controls of a front-end loader can load 15% faster day in and day out, have less downtime, and he's more comfortable while he's working, won't he move more dirt, get more done in the same amount of time, And then if you have a failure, they have parts on demand. They stock their warehouse with parts and service so that if you ever need a repair, that truck's going to be out there fixing you up, and your turnaround time on repairs is much higher, because if a machine goes down, doggone it, those people are standing there and you're paying payroll and you're wasting money and you're losing money. So the value proposition is efficiencies and value focused, okay? Good, wise business owners understand that if you are a better value and add efficiencies into their business and help put bottom line tax dollars back in their pocket, that you're going to be an amazing value. So you have to think through a couple things. Remember the three value propositions. One, you're going to mitigate their taxes. But you can, once you kind of set up the game plan to mitigate the taxes, they might not need you anymore. But remember that that write-off, if they run a 20% net profit, that means that, you know, divide it by 0.20, you're going to see how much of an impact to their revenue you actually hit when you help them keep more of their money. The second thing is, and these are efficiencies, save them time by you doing the bookkeeping, accounting, and tax, by you just making their life easy. And in fact, when you're pitching in front of somebody for this outsourced accountant model, I want you to remember that there's value in just you being the one-stop shop. When it becomes tax time and they have a payroll company or a payroll solution and then a bookkeeping solution and then a tax solution and then a financial planner, I'm telling you, believe me, because I've been on this game for long enough to know that those business owners are super frustrated and annoyed whenever they have to coordinate papers back and forth and send reports back and forth and get this and get that and send it in. And just you doing that will save them money and bring them efficiencies. So your biggest worst enemy is your tendency to think about cost. You have to interpret value. And I think the three ways: keeping compliant so that your business is on sound ground, saving them time by providing them the services and helping them mitigate taxes impacting their bottom line. Good luck. If you need website, if you need digital marketing, you want help getting your Google reviews on advertisement with Google Ads, give me a call, Rob at feedbackwrench.com. Good luck, guys.